In honor of this generation, I type my speech on my iPhone. I can tell you all from experience that you will never have these days back again. Most of you will go on to college, meet new friends that'll become your new best friends, meet new young men and young women who will become the new person that you think you're gonna spend the rest of your lives with. And that may sound heartbreaking in this very moment, but if I won't tell the truth of my experience, then I shouldn't speak at all. I'll share a story with you guys. When I was in 11th grade, I dated a girl that was in the 12th grade. And I thought I was doing something. I thought I was a man. And she graduated, she went to a school that was local. She stayed in Oakland, so we still hung out, we were still together. And it was the best thing ever. I was in love. I was telling my parents, we're gonna be together forever. I'm never letting her go. I was jealous about everything. It was my first, you know, the first time that I was like that about a girl. I thought it was gonna be forever. So, fast forward to me graduating. I'm moving on. I'm going to school in Utah. And she's like, I don't want you to leave. And my parents like, you got a full ride scholarship, you gotta go. Like, that little puppy love is gonna be over. You gotta go. So I decide I'm gonna go to school in Utah, and she's upset with me. So we going back and forth about it. I decide to go, she stays. And about a week into the school year, we break up. And I thought that was the worst thing in the world. I was heartbroken. I didn't know what to do. I was like, this is it. I gotta go home. My life is over. I was broken. And this is a true story, but I think that was when I turned into my best self. I got motivated after that. I was able to get back to myself. I wasn't consumed by the things that I thought was all that mattered to me in my life. So that's just a short story for you guys. You know, my first experience with heartbreak. So some of y'all might experience that. It's gonna be okay. To many people, graduating high school is what is expected. But in life, anything that takes work to accomplish deserves to be acknowledged. Even if it's just a certificate saying you got the job done. Because the truth is, in high school, just like in life, many people just don't get the job done. So give yourselves a hand. I look back at my high school graduation. And one thing that comes to mind when I think about it is how much everybody was just positive. Everybody had good energy and everybody had high hopes. I felt encouraged and inspired to go out into the world and do great things. And looking back at it, I wish we could go back to that day and everybody could start over, because now when I go home, I see some friends that I thought would go on to do great things and other people who I didn't think would do so well. You know, I was worried about some people. And those are the people sometimes that end up doing great, and the people you expect a lot of, sometimes they don't end up doing as well. And it's not because of, you know, them directly all the time. Sometimes life just hits people harder. And it happens, that's a part of life. Some people go through things that others don't. Some people go through things that they just never bounce back from. And, you know, we should all be thankful for having family and having a support system, having people around us that continue to push us in the right direction, continue to have our back. So you guys probably wouldn't be here if you didn't have all these beautiful people behind you to support you and continue to push you in the right direction. But part of growing up is dealing with obstacles. You just never know what life is going to throw at you. What you plan to do in life, it will not be a smooth road to get there. There will be pain, suffering, stress, heartbreak, setbacks, haters. I know y'all know about haters. Y'all probably call each other that when y'all ain't in class. And it's the people who are the most committed to what they had high hopes to become that come out where they intended. A mentor of mine once shared a quote with me that I still live by to this day. And that quote is, a smooth sea never made a skillful sailor. So for the rest of your lives, I challenge all you guys to be resilient, be steady, and even when times are hard, because in the end, you'll be better off with all the triumph and the struggle that you go through. At your age, this is funny, just reading this. Because it's so true. This is like really the truth. At your age, I was so anxious and ready to grow up. I wanted to be an adult. I wanted to party, have fun, travel, make money, many other things. And now, looking back, I wish I had just enjoyed my life, you know, enjoyed being a kid. It was things that in college, on campus, they had foam parties and floaties and a bunch of stuff like that, and I was too cool for it. And now I look back and I wish I had enjoyed those moments with my roommates and my classmates and my teammates, because we'll never get it back again. And now, my roommates, we've been trying to plan vacation for 4 or 5 years now, and I still haven't seen them. So it puts things in perspective. Time flies, things go by, and you can never get it back. So on top of me wishing I had enjoyed my life, I think it's just important to really take that into consideration. It's just as important as you guys being focused on school, being driven, attacking your goals. Live your life to the fullest, because it's equally as important. I just had my 10-year high school reunion, and in my mind, we were just in school 5 years ago. It went by just like that, fast. So treat your friends right, treat your family right, care about people, do the right things the right way, don't be followers. Because before you know it, you'll be 30 years old and wondering where the time went. Some of your friends now you may not see after graduation. Accidents happen, health happens, age happens to the people you love. So go out and be the people who live with a purpose. Do things that will keep those high hopes alive, because I've seen them die for many people I grew up with, family and friends. But for many of you that will do what you set out to do, you'll be in position to pick up the ones who stumble and fall and the ones who may be lost. I know this from experience, and if I can't tell you the truth from my experience, then I shouldn't speak at all. So congratulations to you guys. This is a great accomplishment, so give yourselves a round of applause. I don't know how familiar you guys are with Four Bar Friday. Today is Friday, right? So it's only right I leave y'all with four bars. The world is for the taking, and it's meant for you to thrive. And anything is possible, commitment and some drive. Today is all for you, and I love to see you fly. So I ask for one favor, keep the hope alive.